how dangerous on a scale of 1 to 10 is it?
100.
Now, tell me what's about to happen.
I'll go underwater. The lid will be closed and padlocked shut. A chain will be wrapped around my neck. My hands will be handcuffed on the outside of the box. The lock around my neck and the handcuffs I'll be attempting to pick using a lock pick. But the last lock, the one that keeps the lid closed, and that one's a little different. So I'm going to invite Ant and Dec on stage, if you would, please. Can we have a round of applause? Here on the table, I have a glass. It contains 20 keys. None of these keys will open that lock. Now, we don't have time to go through all 20, so take 3 or 4 at random, try them in the lock. When you've tried them, drop them in the glass, please. I have one more key. This is the one that opens the lock. Would you try that in the lock now, please? As he's doing that, would you put up all the keys in the glass?
Yes.
Would you take the key out and put it in the glass with the 20 that don't?
Like that?
Yes. Now, put your hand on top and shake up the keys.
Oh, he's nuts.
Oh, my God.
The last lock is like trying to find a needle in a haystack. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, judges, Ant and Dec.
Now, tell me, what should we be looking out for? Is this a period of time or what?
I'm going to try and do it in a minute and a half, but if we start getting up around a minute 40, minute 50 underwater, holding my breath, then we're starting to have problems. If I start floating and I pass out, then you get me out.
Okay, got it. Good luck.
Thank you.
Oh my God.
I mean, this is crazy.
I actually feel sick already.
Yeah. These are the acts that actually can go wrong. Okay.
lovely.
That's my phone. Whoa.
Oh, and the heart goes back in.